Hi there, this is Wasim Asgar. Are you in your final year of electrical engineering and thinking about taking FE electrical and computer exam? In this video, I'm going to go over some key strategies that can help you manage your workload while you are completing your studies, at the same time prepare effectively for the FE electrical and computer exam. As you probably know, FE electrical and computer exam is a very comprehensive test. It covers pretty much the entire undergraduate engineering coursework of a typical electrical and computer engineering degree. Understanding this scope is crucial to your success on the exam. My first advice to you, if you plan on taking the FE electrical and computer exam soon, is to get started on this journey as soon as possible. So if you want to graduate not only with your degree but also with the EIT certificate, then it's a good idea to start planning sooner rather than later. As compared to a lot of other candidates who are taking the FE electrical and computer, you have a significant advantage, and that advantage stems from the fact that a lot of exam topics are probably relatively fresh in your mind. You would have probably taken circuits 1, power systems, electronics, microelectronics, digital systems, electromagnetics in the last 1, 2, or maybe 3 years. If you compare your scenario with folks who've been out of school for a long time, I have a lot of students who are in my program who have been out of school for 5, 10, 15, sometimes even 20 years, and their challenges are very different from your challenges. Because the last time they did any type of circuit analysis or electronics or control systems was several years ago. In their case though, they have a very clear motivation as to why they want to get the FE exam done. And typically that comes down to getting the promotions, bonuses, salary increase, because a lot of employers, regardless of your experience level, tie your promotions or certain titles to passing the FE exam and getting your PE license. And preparing for this exam with a full-time job is also challenging. So kudos to you for taking the initiative and trying to get this done before you even graduate, or maybe soon after you graduate. I would strongly recommend you to keep track of your lectures, coursework, textbooks that you use to prepare for different subjects within your undergraduate engineering. Now, there's a balancing act that you have to do when you're preparing for the FE electrical and computer exam. When you did circuits 1 or circuits 2, it would have been a lot more in-depth. When you took circuits 1, circuits 2, microelectronics, digital systems, control systems, electromagnetics, the level of depth that you went into for each one of these courses is slightly different from what you need to do for the FE electrical and computer exam. And that's where you have to improvise. Now, to help my students who are enrolled in my FE electrical and computer exam preparation program, I've developed an on-demand program as well as a live training program. Within the on-demand program, I have 250 plus lectures, over 100 quizzes, practice exams, mini exams that can help you fast track your exam preparation. I go over every single concept in detail, help you do a lot of practice problems with detailed solutions, and help you prepare for the exam in a relatively short period of time. So we need to actively balance the level of depth that we are going into while making sure that we cover the entire ground for the FE electrical and computer exam specification. The other challenge with the FE electrical and computer exam is the fact that it gives you only 3 minutes per question. There are 110 questions on the exam, and you have 5 hours and 40 minutes to tackle those problems. That roughly translates into 3 minutes per question. So not only do you need to make sure that you understand the concepts, the theory, and the approach and the steps, the calculations to do the problems, but you also need to do them relatively quickly. And that comes with the sound theoretical understanding combined with a lot of practice. So make sure that you're not only comfortable with the concepts, but you're doing enough practice problems along the way as well. One of the main challenges that you're going to run in your final year of studying while you're preparing for the FE electrical and computer exam are basically other demands on your time. You're probably still keeping up with some of the homework assignments with your studies. You're probably keeping up with the capstone project, have other projects and assignments, final exams that you have to take care of, quizzes, some lab work and whatnot. And the way to make sure that every single day, every single week, you are able to squeeze sufficient amount of time for your FE electrical and computer exam preparation is by creating a consistent schedule. Maybe early in the day or at the tail end of your day, set aside 1 to 2 hours of study time on a regular basis. And when you have more opportunity to study, you exactly know where your time should be going. And because you have that advantage of being in touch with academics, you can leverage that quite effectively. When you're preparing for the FE electrical and computer exam while managing other responsibilities, it is very easy to get overwhelmed. So make sure that you are taking regular breaks, getting ample amount of rest, sleep, taking good care of your diet, and avoiding an outright burnout. Because in the pursuit of the EID certificate, you don't want to negatively impact your studies, especially when you're this close to graduation. I hope you found this video helpful, and I'd like to thank you for your time, and would like to actually congratulate you for taking this initiative to even think about getting that electrical and computer exam out of the way, because as you probably know that regardless of what type of job market we are in, if you have any type of edge over the competition, whether it is in the form of grad studies, whether it's in the form of stellar grades, whether it's in the form of an internship, whether you have a very good school name that you're graduating from, or an EIT certificate, any type of advantage that helps you stand out from the crowd will hopefully result in more job offers and opportunities. So this additional bit of effort that you're going to be putting in towards your FE exam preparation and getting the EIT certificate before you even graduate can actually pay dividends down the road. And if you want to learn more about preparation of FE Electrical and Computer exam and the P Power exam, then check out these playlists over here. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you soon in the next video.